Well, hi, my name is Cindy. Miss Cindy is what most people call me. And I do children's ministry here at First Presbyterian Church. You may be watching this video because you received, during our drive-through on December 20th, a packet that told you how to make a shadow nativity box. So these are the directions on how to do that. But first, I just want to say that telling the story of the first Christmas is a favorite thing to do during Christmas time. I'm thrilled that you picked up a shadow box theater and that you're going to include this as part of your Christmas celebration. This illustrated shadow box theater provides you with the opportunity to tell the extraordinary story of Jesus's birth in a creative way, and then using light and color and shadows and designs, designed characters and the scenery to pull it all together, including with the script. You should have received in your packet a sheet like this, which gives you the directions on how to do this and also tells you what you need. Most of the stuff is stuff that you should have at home, and you should have all the handouts that we sent home with you, so that should be helpful. But don't forget to look on the back of your sheet, because on the back is a script, and it's a script of the story. So the first thing we need to do is to find a box. I have a box here. It's not a particularly big box, but you don't need a very big box. And this is a part that you're going to want mom and dad or some adult to do, because this is a little bit more complicated and hard to do, and it's just a little dangerous. You could also take a knife, or your parents could take a knife from the kitchen, and just gonna wanna cut the bottom of the box out. So I've done most of the cutting already, and I'm gonna take the back off of my box so that you can see what it will look like. This is what we want, is we just want a box like this with the no back on the back. You can kind of set that aside because you're not going to use that for a few minutes. But the next step, what you are going to do, and this is something you could be doing while your adult is cutting out the bottom of your box, is the first three sheets of your packet, they are going to be numbered 1, 2, and 3. These sheets need to be decorated, colored. So you're going to want to use lots of bright colors, and you're going to want to color these and make them as pretty as you can. Well, now that I've gotten most of my things colored, I'm gonna try to cut them out. And you're gonna see on some of your sheets, there's a little pair of scissors and a black line. And you can cut them just straight down that black line if you want. And you can take these whole sections and you can tape them onto your tape or glue them right onto your box like this. You could be very decorative and you could, you know, put this all the way along the side like this, or you could cut it out as individual pieces and decorate it in different sections. So now I've taken my box and I actually glued the colored pieces on the sides, like you can see, and I glued that long one on the top. And now what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna make the back of my box. And in my instructions to you, I said that you could use like parchment paper. If you don't know what that is, an adult in your house probably does. It's not the kind of thing you always have around. So I realized that you could also use tissue paper. So that's what's down here, is just this little piece of tissue paper. This one's a little bit yellow, but you could use white. Just to make that work, you set your box down. And I took a pen because I think I can see it better. And I'm just going to draw all the way around the edge of the box with my pen. Just make a little mark. If you push too hard, it's just going to rip that tissue paper. And I made a little bit of a mark. It's a little hard to see, but I can see it. And now I'm going to cut that out and tape it onto the back. So now I cut that piece of tissue paper and I have taped it to the back of my box. The tissue works just fine. I found it's a little trickier to tape this on than I thought it would be. So don't be afraid to ask for some help with that, either cutting it out or even getting it started, taping it onto the back. Help it, because that's going to be the back of your box. And a lot of things are going to happen behind your box and maybe in front too, but you want to have that on there good and tight. Just realize it's going to be pretty fragile, okay? Now your next step is going to be cutting out. Well, first you're going to want to color the characters in our shadow back box. So you might want to use small scissors if you have them. You could also have, like, you could cut out these ones that are a little bigger. Okay. There's a reason why I call this a family project, because everybody in the family can be working on it, and everybody in the family can do different parts of it. So this might not be as hard for you to cut out, this little town that you color. That might be not nearly so hard for you to cut out as cutting out the angels, which as I looked at them, I'm like, wow, there's a lot of detail to these. And I think they're gonna be a little trickier to cut out. So I'm gonna have to take my time cutting out the angels. You might wanna ask an adult to do that, though I'm certain that you can do it too. You just need to take some time and do it very slowly. Remember, this is really a family project. You guys can all participate and make your nativity shadow box. Okay, I'll be back when I've got all my things finished cutting. Well, I have cut out some of my characters here and my backdrop here, and I've gone ahead and taken the chance to go ahead and tape all of my little characters here onto a toothpick. So all I really did is take a little piece of tape. Here's Mary, and I'm gonna tape that toothpick right onto the back of her like that, just kind of fold that tape around. And then I can make Mary move around like a character. So I can make Mary and Joseph talk. And how are you feeling, Mary? I'm doing fine, good. And if I want, I've also put baby Jesus here. He's in the manger, he's right between them. And they can all be my characters. Here's my angel, he can fly. Mm-hmm. Here's another angel. I'm gonna kind of put this together a little bit, but before I do, there's one other thing that you might need to have. I think I might have put it on your list. I hope so. If I didn't, then it might be something you wanna get. And I would tell you that it makes things a lot easier. So this is actually what they call floral foam. And floral foam is just a fancy name for a foam. I guess florists use it sometimes. And I bought this at the Dollar Tree. It was only a dollar. And floral foam is great for sticking these little characters in, right? So you can stick their little toothpicks in and make a little scene that way. So I would recommend that you get some of this. The other thing you can use is styrofoam. And you may have a lot of that sitting around, especially after Christmas with all packages and such. And anything that you can stick a toothpick into will work really great. And then you can be able to move your characters around inside your shadow box and do the play. So you might want to look for some of that. Okay, I ended up taking my floral foam and cutting it into a smaller piece like this. So I am going to go ahead and put my Joseph in there. And I'm going to put Mary in there. And I'm gonna put my baby Jesus in there. Might have to put him down a little further, right? Like that. And you can move those around and play with them a little bit like that. Mm-hmm. And that'll be where that is. And then on the back of my shadow box, I've decided I'm going to attach my little town. And I think I'm just gonna do that by using some tape and taping it with the colored side down on the tissue paper, like that. Yep, now you could tape it inside your box too. You're certainly welcome to do that as well. And then what's gonna happen is when I'm gonna set this up and I will put a light on the back and it will shine through and you'll be able to see the little town through there, right? So there's the little town, and then Mary and Joseph are gonna be in there, and then I can set them in there like that. I'm gonna be able to set them into my stage like that. So now I'm gonna let you go ahead and finish your other characters, And the other characters that we have is another sheet, and that is a sheet of sheep and of the wise men and shepherds. Actually, I think these are the shepherds. And the star and some stars and some bushes. So those things can all be cut out. If you want them to move around and be part of your scene, you can put them on a toothpick. Otherwise, you can just glue them around the edges or in the back. And I'm going to work on all of this here. And then when I come back, I will have my finished project for you. And I'm going to get a flashlight and shine it from the back so you can see what it looks like. Well, boys and girls, here's my finished project. I realize it looks a little crowded. There's a lot of things in there, but I cut out the shepherds and the sheep, the stars and the angels, and you can probably see that I attached some of the angels on the inside of the box, and I put some on the outside too. I put some on the popsicle sticks or on the toothpicks as well. And the sheep I put on toothpicks and put them in the front there. So let me show you what I have behind here. You can use a flashlight, which a lot of people will use. I decided at my house I have these candles. Let me reach behind one and get one for you so you can see what it looks like. This is the candles that I have. And these are battery powered candles. So there's no flame inside, see? But they have a nice glow to them. So I just set up those candles. And so that's how the light is shining through. That is my shadow box nativity. And I hope that you've had a good time making that as a family, or even if you've made it by yourself. It's something that you can use all through Christmas. Remember that you can take the characters and move them around and make it into a play where you play out the part where Joseph is visited by the angel, or even when Mary is visited by the angel. It's really fun to retell the story. It's nice to tell it for yourself. It's nice to tell it to your family. So I hope this is something that you will enjoy. And I do hope that you have a wonderful Christmas. Merry Christmas, and God bless you.